Okay, guys, I think people are started joining. We also are on YouTube Live. So far, we have 15 people here and 4 people in YouTube. I think, Mahindra, let's wait for 5 more minutes and then we'll begin.
Sure, sure, Niladri. Am I audible?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, we can wait for a few more minutes. Yeah, let me know once we have the sufficient quorum.
Yeah, we have 2 more minutes, then we'll begin. I think we have almost 19 members here. And in YouTube, we have 13 who are watching us live. All right, guys, I think it's now 5 minutes over the expected time. We can start now. Today we'll be talking about the anti-patterns from a Scrum Master perspective. Mahendra Hotte will be our presenter and speaker. I'm not going into the introductions for Mahendra. Mahendra will talk about something about himself before we start. I think we can go over to Mahendra now.
Thanks, Niladri. Good evening, good morning, in wherever, whichever time zones that you are in. I pray all of you are safe and doing well in these testing times. If there's some unfortunate on any of your near and dear ones are not keeping well, they are in my prayers. So let's get started. So I'll just share my screen. Can you confirm? Is this?
Yes, it's coming. I can able to see your screen. Yeah.
Okay. Thanks. Okay. So today, as Niladri mentioned, we'll talk about role-related anti-patterns, predominantly on Scrum Masters, and I've made up some names on Scrum Masters. So I've given them some titles. It is just to be a bit more creative. On my side, so it's just my made up terms, so it's nothing official about the terms and the that you see in the subsequent slide. A quick introduction of who am I. So started my career with the Air Force as a commissioned officer way back in 94. Was there for 6 years. Then my second innings, as we say in our cricketing terms, was in the IT sector. So being a developer, project lead, QA manager, program manager, then became a Scrum Master. Was a Scrum Master for a good 4 to 5 years. So I've done a lot of mistakes, proud to have done those mistakes because that's where I learned. For the past 4-5 years, I've been an Agile coach, part of the transformations of quite a few big organizations. I have a YouTube channel of mine wherein I post my videos. You can go and visit it. And I firmly believe in being a team player and sharing knowledge. And I am a continuous learner. I try to keep on upgrading myself, be it on the Agile side, DevOps, or the technical side. So that's a brief introduction of me. So let's get started. As I mentioned, these titles that I've given over here, manager, Scrum Master, and all are my made-up terms. So just to give a reference to the pattern, the anti-pattern that I'm referring to regarding the Scrum Master. So first one is the manager. Some basic housekeeping. Sorry, I forgot. So Niladri, I'll have a small break in between. So for sure. Questions. So if you can monitor the questions, we can take the questions during that.
I'll look into the questions coming on the YouTube channel or the chat window. If someone have some questions, please raise your hand from the Zoom tool, and we'll take all the questions when we'll be having a logical break in between.
Yeah, I have a small logical 5 minute break, and then we'll continue. And the leftover questions, we'll take it towards the end. So it would not be possible for me to answer questions in between. So it sort of breaks the flow. Okay, thanks. So first one, I call it as a manager Scrum Master. So here it is not uncommon that we see a lot of certificates now on the market. So, and I, if you see in LinkedIn, you can see certificates literally going from earth to the moon type and back type of a thing. So many logos and certificates. So certificates does give a perspective. I'm not against any certificate, but having a lot of certificates and still having a strong flavor of a command and control is a big anti-pattern. While a Scrum Master is expected to be a servant leader. So servant leader is a very, is a skill that needs to be really learned. And predominantly for people like old termers, like I would like me as well, who have been in the industry for quite some time in the erstwhile ways of working, we'll have to make a cautious effort to pick up the soft skills of being a servant leader. So that is what is expected from a Scrum Master. What is a servant leader and what are the traits of the servant leader and so on and so forth, those attributes and behavior of a servant leader. I'm not getting into the details of that. So that is what is expected from a Scrum Master being a true servant leader. The next one, I'm calling it as a lazy fiery Scrum Master. This is one, once again, misconception or a myth or whatever you want to call it as, like, okay, yes, the teams need to be self-managed, self-organized. However, that doesn't mean that it is free for all and it is anarchy. And no, there's this thing to the chaos, system to the chaos type of a thing. So it is not free for all. So a lazy fiery Scrum Master is what I am terming it as. So a Scrum Master should let the team run without any guidance or supervision or micromanagement. In the name of being a self-managed team, if he starts doing that, then that's an anti-pattern. While the primary duty of the Scrum Master is to safeguard the agile values and principles. So that is one of the key role, expectation from a Scrum Master. He or she is accountable to uphold this. And with respect to impediments, he has to move heaven and earth to remove impediments for the team. In this process, he might rub some people on the wrong side. So be it. So in the process of upholding the agile values or the Scrum values, the force, focus, openness, respect, if there's a alpha person who's dominating the conversation most of the time, the Scrum Master needs to take it on. So he might rub some people head on the wrong side. So be it, because it is in the interest of the values and the principles. A lazy fiery Scrum Master is an anti-pattern. Rookie Scrum Master. This is one thing that rookie is a term which is given to someone who's a fresher. It comes from the rugby and the American football term, someone who's fresh in the team. So a rookie Scrum Master. So the perception is, okay, the Scrum Master, this comes from nothing to do with the Scrum Master per se, but probably with the organizations who think that Scrum Master's role is very insignificant and anyone and everyone can become a Scrum Master right from the day one. So just because he or she needs to do only the clerical stuff. So that is an anti-pattern. A Scrum Master who's merely ill-prepared or ill-experienced in the servant leadership and who's not able to appreciate the agile values and principles. Probably just know the motions of it. When I say motions of the ceremonies, okay, you have to conduct the stand-up, okay, set up a stand-up meeting, conduct the, facilitate the retro review. So he or she knows only the motions of the ceremonies. So that is an anti-pattern. Well, Scrum Mastery is a very niche skill, to be honest. So it requires a lot of unlearning the old habits and learning the new ways of operating. It does require time and patience. So I'm not telling that a rookie cannot be a Scrum Master. As long as anyone who can uphold the values and principles can be a Scrum Master. This is predominantly an anti-pattern coming from the management side, who just generally appoint someone as a Scrum Master. Clerical Scrum Master. There's a popular belief once again that the Scrum Master is only there to arrange meetings, book conference rooms, and arrange for stationaries and logistics and things like that. So yes, a Scrum Master needs to do it. He has to facilitate it. but that is not the primary job of the Scrum Master. That any tool can do. So that is not the role. That's not the primary responsibility of the Scrum Master. And it is for us as Scrum Masters to make a conscious effort not to be reduced to a clerical Scrum Master. Then we lose the charm in that work. So it is not exciting to just keep on doing this. We ourselves will feel frustrated. So it is for us as Scrum Masters also to make that effort not to be reduced to be just a clerical person out there. While the Scrum Master role is much more than just setting meetings and arranging logistics. In fact, the Scrum Master's role is all about raising the bar as well. When I say raising the bar, the team has to continuously improve the various waste that is there, the various seven lean waste that are there in the system. The Scrum Master has to look out for them, remove them, and ensure that it has been discussed. Continuous improvement is part of the one of the primary responsibilities of Scrum Master. So it is much more than just being a clerical job of arranging meetings and logistics and things like that. Next one, I'm calling it as a technical Scrum Master. This generally happens when organizations move from the waterfall way of working and they take up agile transformation. So the general tendency is, okay, there's a project lead or a product lead or a technical person who is very sound technically, and he or she is part of the erstwhile ways of working and the in charge of a particular module or a component. Okay, let's make him a Scrum Master. So that is what I'm naming as a technical Scrum Master. The anti-pattern that follows in that setup is the Scrum Master starts directing or dictating the how part of the stories as well. The story is basically the what. The what does the customer want? It is about the what, why, and who. The how is left to the team. The implementation, the technicalities of how a story is implemented is supposed to be owned and left to the team. Now, it is very difficult for someone who's been in that role, technical role, hardcore technical role, automatically to switch and stop directing the team on the technical aspects. If he or she is able to do it, I'm not telling that he or she should not give the expert advice. That is there. But directing the how and taking away the ownership of the how from the team members is an anti-pattern. So as I mentioned, the expectation is the team collectively owns the how of the stories that are implemented, no one else. Next one, I'm calling it as an harmony Scrum Master. So this is a behavior wherein, yes, a team, there should be a lot of harmony in the team. There should not be a real infight. And the atmosphere should be very cordial. All that is good. And if the Scrum Master starts sweeping the conflict and the problems under the rug, and if he or she is not using the retrospectives to address them openly, then that's an anti-pattern. This predominantly comes from the behavior wherein, or the fact from wherein the Scrum Master is trying to accommodate or bow to the politics that is there in the organization, or the political power, or the alpha person in the organization. And the Scrum Master just bends heads over heel to meet the organization needs, neglecting the values, Scrum values, or the agile values and principles. So that's an anti-pattern. While the expectation is, it's quite natural when in the agile ways of working as compared to the erstwhile ways, we interact a lot, we communicate a lot. So conflicts are natural. So the Scrum Master should focus the issue on hand and rather than the individuals. So the problem should be solved by focusing on the issue, fix the system, not the person. That should be the approach. And the Scrum Master should address all of this in the retrospective. In fact, conflicts are good. Healthy conflicts are always good. That is where the improvements come in. If everyone is saying yes, 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 then that is not the right situation. So this is what is in Harmony Scrum Master. This is once again coming from the erstwhile mindset, utilization. The Scrum Master is always worried about the number of hours. So be it any of the R tools, the Agile ALM tools, be it Jira, version one, Rally, Jazz, or any one of these. We do have a provision to log the hours against individual tasks and things like that. So the Scrum Master is, this is coming from the erstwhile mindset of utilization. He or she is worried mainly on the number of hours an individual puts in into the sprint. While the Scrum Master should focus on the outcome, outcome is basically the sprint goal, rather than the output. So this is what is a fundamental difference that we need to understand between what is an outcome and what is an output. So 100% utilization, I'll give you some simple example. The number of trainings conducted. So it's basically an output for a training department. Okay, 10 trainings, 20 trainings against so-and-so skill set and things. It's an output. But what is the outcome? How these trainings have been implemented or practiced in the project? That's an outcome. So there's a fundamental difference between outcome and output. The Scrum Master should be outcome-oriented rather than an output-oriented. Moving on, a pushy Scrum Master. Once again, like the Scrum Master in Jira, the or in any of the tool, the tag out there, the field out there is the story is assigned to, or the task is assigned to. So if I'm given an opportunity, I would say self-owned by, rather than assigned to. This word assigned to itself gives that feeling that, okay, I'm assigning something to you. So not going into the tooling aspect of it. And if the Scrum Master is assigning task, or even lets anyone, be it the product owner or the technical lead or the architect who's assigning tasks to the team members, then that's an anti-pattern. So just not, Scrum Master, anyone doing it and the Scrum Master not doing anything about it, I call him as a pushy Scrum Master. While the team members are expected to be self-managed and working on a pull mode and pick up tasks from the sprint backlog. So it should work on a pull mode. That should be the exception. I'm calling this guy as a blind Scrum Master. What do we mean by that? The primary role of the Scrum Master is ensure that impediments are resolved. So that is one of the primary roles. We will hang on to this because you might think that I am conflicting myself with impediments when we go to the next subsequent slides. But yes, one of the responsibilities of the Scrum Master is impediments. If a Scrum Master is not able to identify impediments in the sprint and resolve them, I call him as a blind to the impediments. It's very common in the daily standard that there are certain individuals who are struggling to complete some task. So it is their culture or it is their inherent behavior. They cannot openly talk. So they're struggling to tell that I'm stuck, but each one of us can get a feeling, okay, so-and-so person is stuck for so-and-so reason. And probably that person is not able to articulate that he or she requires help. The Scrum Master should look out for those signs and pick them up and help resolve these impediments. So that is where, so just a Scrum Master setting up a daily stand-up and just being a mute spectator is a big no-no. You'll have to look out both those signs of these impediments and people struggling to articulate that. Next one, I'm calling him as a stagnant Scrum Master. 2 weeks is quite a long period is what I would say. So for generally, we have 2 week sprints. There are teams which I've seen, it's a 1 week sprint. I've seen teams doing a 3 to 4 week sprint also. So whatever the sprint duration, 2 weeks itself, 2 weeks itself is a long duration. So during this 2 weeks duration, the Scrum Master needs to keep his or her ears and eyes open to look out for opportunities and gather data that can be discussed in the retrospective, because retrospective is where the continuous improvement happens. One of the primary three pillars of Scrum, one of the two pillars of Scrum is inspect and adapt, the third being transparency. So inspect and adapt, if inspect and adapt is not happening, then we are not scrumming in the right way. The Scrum Master plays a very important role in ensuring that in retrospectives do happen and happen in the right spirit. And skipping Scrum retrospectives is I would say is a real sin. I call this guy as a Superman Scrum Master. This is once again coming from my anti-pattern because of the management side. The Scrum Master is expected to play as a the role of a Scrum Master for more than one or two. Two is okay for whatever reasons that the organization has. But being a Scrum Master, I've seen Scrum Masters or people being Scrum Masters for three or four teams. He or she just cannot do justice if a Scrum Master is made to operate like that. At any point of time, two is this thing based on the experience, that there's no logical reason to it. Based on my experience, what I've seen is more than two, he or she cannot do justice to the team. Okay, so I'll take a quick pause. So we're at the hour, 9 o'clock now, for 5 minutes. Niladri, if there are any questions.
Right, let me quickly look into the chat window. I don't have anything in chat, but we have a couple of comments on the YouTube. I will just go through them. Few of them questions, few of them are comments. Majority of them came from a person named Devanjan Sengupta. First comment, anti-pattern 2 was neat, very common anti-pattern. So when we are talking about 2, I'm not sure which was 2.
And then, yeah.
So
lazy feeling Scrum Master.
Okay. All right. The another point, anti-pattern 4 is also somewhat linked to anti-pattern 2. Again, a common interpretations of the role.
True. So it's just a behavior that is different, wherein here he or she is doing only clerical work. Here, what I'm trying to tell is, we as Scrum Masters have a big role in reducing ourselves to this, which we should avoid. That is what I'm trying to bring over here.
Right. Another good one, anti-pattern 6. I am commenting here to compliment on your choice of scenarios. Nice. Okay, next one, same from Devanjan, would like to comment on anti-pattern 7. At times, it could be a valuable source of empirical data. Niladri, can you please ask Mahendra to share his view on anti-pattern 7, WRT, my question.
Devanjan. Yeah. So empirical data, yes, it's okay. So I'm not against collecting this data. So when I understand, if I can rephrase your question, Devanjan, so what is the time that is required to complete so and so? It's okay for that. But when it is coming from that mindset, okay, or let me put it this way. When we do the sprint planning, so the normal way is we take the, as a Scrum Master, I'll take the capacity of the team, whoever is on leave and so on and so forth. And in the sprint planning, we end up breaking down the what to the how. And now that's a problem comes. So, okay, everything is broken down to the how and it is bite-sized. It should not be more than 6 to 8 hours. Are all of you occupied 100%? Running a person at 100% capacity, it is like riding the bike at optimal high speed continuously for a long time. It's a burnout case. So rather than looking at the utilization of the team members, as long as the sprint goal is accomplished and there's enough of transparency and there's no hiding place so that people can't fool each other and there's a lot of self-management, we need not even get into this. That's what I'm trying to tell. Rather than being utilization focused, be on outcome focused. And the team will improve automatically. I hope I clarified. I don't know.
Yeah. So there are many questions now suddenly came up. Let's go through quickly as we can. Same from Devanjan Sengupta, anti-pattern 9 is also somewhat linked to 6. Maybe she is trying to be politically correct. Good one again. Anti-pattern 11, unavoidable at times, definitely an anti-pattern though. That's 11, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, here unfortunately, a scrum master has no role, or he or she can express that I'm overloaded. And if the, so here I would say, make sure that you take your coach along, or make sure that you take the manager into confidence and express your views. So at the end of the day, scrum master is also coach to the organization also. That's what I would say.
Okay. In the chat window over here, I'll go with Prakash, who mentioned team members, scrum master. It is very common. I'm not sure it's a questions or experience he had shared, but Mahendra, you want to talk about something?
I'll try to rephrase. So when probably the person who's telling is a team member, scrum master, it's in our Zoom itself, is it? Probably that person can unmute and talk. What did he actually
mean? Prakash, you want to exactly mention what exactly you want to talk about?
Yes, am I audible?
Yes. Yeah, Prakash, you are. Yeah.
Two things. First, I just wanted to mention, like, I saw many a times, like, a senior member or a member who is the team for last 6 or 1 year, he had been asked by the manager or someone else to play the role of scrum master as well as the team member. That I saw a case generally in all the organization. I'm not saying on the all organization, but I found this thing. And regarding the your point, anti-pattern point A, generally, like when you were talking about post-scrum master, where in that scenario, I saw the things like scrum master asked the senior member or old member of team who is with the team for last 1 year or more than that. Generally, he asked that particular person to assign the task accordingly to other person, because if he's not technical enough or he's not aware about the stuff, they generally ask, like, you can go ahead and assign the task as per their complexity and their, to the person knowledge.
Okay, so I made note. I'll answer both your this thing, Prakash. First is a team member scrum master. So one of the team members become a scrum master. It's perfectly fine. So what you're probably trying to tell us, the scrum master is playing a dual role. I am a developer as well as a scrum master. So is that the scenario, Prakash? Or I'm a tester as well as See, that is okay. See, as long as I'm able to, as long as I have that maturity and I can wear both the hats and do justice to both the roles. So that is okay, but that requires a lot of time to master that skill. So it's okay as long as we are not able to, I can do the justice of being a scrum master, uphold all the values and principles. So I would rather say when a team, when an organization undergoes a transformation, have a scrum master, master that role first, let that person master that role first, and then that role can play a dual role. See, this comes from that thought process of the management that the scrum master is not an important role. The scrum master is just a part-time job which can be accomplished. So it comes from that thought process. So that is where this goes wrong.
Yeah, that's right. This is my point. Like generally, organization or management have such kind of thought process, like it's not a 8 hours job or it's a 2 or 3 hours job, so portion can handle both of the stuff.
Why it's a 3 hour job? Because we have reduced ourselves to become a clerical person, or the other patterns that I see. It is for us to showcase that it is a full time job, and I have got, it is not just a clerical work. So we are at 5 minutes now. So I'll just answer this next one of Pushi, and then we can move on. We can take the rest of the questions there. So Pushi,
carry on. You are referring that, yeah.
Yeah, I need to complete it because I made that. So Pushi Scrum Master, once again, this is, so here, see, if it is a fresher right of the college, and if a project lead who's 8, 9, X number of years in the product and things like that, if he or she is, okay, probably it is okay, you take it type of a thing, that's, I can understand. But if a project lead is assigning, thinking that the other person can, so-and-so person A can do, but person B cannot do, it is coming from that erstwhile mindset. So there are different ways of handling it. So break it down, let them pick it up. So if the person B has been in the project in that particular, he might not be an expert in that particular module, but it is still the same technology, same product, same domain. So let that person B pick up the low hanging fruit. So be it. Nah. So why are we, why am I as a project lead taking away that liberty from that person B to pick up something? That is where it comes. I as a project lead can tell, give advice on that, but I cannot take ownership. I cannot deny person B from picking up something. That is where it is coming from, Prakash. Let's move on. So we can take the subsequent questions later. Okay, moving on. So delivery manager, Scrum Master. This is one big anti-pattern we generally see. The Scrum Master is made responsible for the overall delivery of the committed sprint goal. Once again, nothing from the Scrum Master's side, but it is the management thinking. Because it is in the erstwhile ways of working, the project manager was held accountable for all the deliverables that the team is doing. It is coming from that mindset. So the same thing flows when we move into the agile ways or the Scrum ways of working. The Scrum Master is held accountable for the delivery of the committed sprint goal, while the team is held accountable and responsible for the sprint goal. This is a drastic 180 degree shift, mindset shift. So this should be the expectation. The team is held accountable and responsible for the sprint goal. Proxy Scrum Master, though this thing is wrong. So the Scrum Master is expected to drive the functional enhancements also. In the erstwhile ways of working, I as a project manager picked up the requirements from the customers or the clients and things like that. And I was understanding the requirements and I was doing everything. So the same thing flows. So here the Scrum Master who's expected to drive the functional aspects of it is a big guaranteed pattern. While it is a product owner's responsibility to drive the functional requirements. The product owner is responsible for the ROI, return of investment of the team. While the Scrum Master is responsible for the values and the principles, the impediments, and those things that we just, servant leadership, the coaching the team, he or she is responsible for that, not for the functional requirements. Bean counter Scrum Master. So here, once again, it is coming from the erstwhile mindset. The estimates in the erstwhile ways of working was given by the project lead or I as a project manager. So now the Scrum Master is expected to review and validate if the estimates are right. Now, the estimates, I generally prefer to use the word sizing. Sizing of the stories resides with the team which is delivering it. The estimates are owned by the team, not by anyone else. You might feel that I'm contradicting over here. Scrum Master. The Scrum Master handles all the impediments of the teams. It's an anti-pattern. The idea should be to make the team self-managed and self-organized. Even if small impediments are being handled by the Scrum Master, then we are taking away that, or we are not letting the team grow to become a self-managed. So if a Scrum Master is spoon feeding the team for everything, then that's an anti-pattern. Metrics, Scrum Master here, when I meant metrics, an incorrect understanding of the metrics. The problem with these metrics are, if they're misunderstood, then they really give a wrong connotation. For example, velocity. So if the Scrum Master doesn't understand what a velocity is and what is it used for, then it is a big problem. I'll give a simple example. Okay, the velocity of the team is increasing day by day. Okay, we are very productive. No, velocity has got no connotation to productivity. Yes, over a period of time, it's a gradual progression that the velocity will increase. But measuring velocity as a measure of productivity is a big misunderstanding. So therefore, a Scrum Master doesn't understand the burn down chart. So how the burn down, and the Scrum Master feels that he's responsible for the burn down chart. It's an anti-pattern. So a Scrum Master should have a firm understanding of the matrices and should know what is a vanilla metric and what is a real metric. So there are quite a few metrics in the erstwhile world, which I also did in my earlier project management days. If I think back on them now, I feel, why did I collect them? Probably just the organization mandated, and probably the organizations also were not mature enough. For example, number of test cases executed and number of test cases passed and failed. It has got nothing to do with the quality of the product. So we should start re-looking at the metrics logically, whether it's a plain vanilla metric or a real metric, which we can infer and make some decisions on them. Secret agent Scrum Master. The Scrum Master, instead of serving the team, acts as a secret agent to the line manager. The line manager gathers all insider information through the Scrum Master. This is quite common, and there's a big anti-pattern. The Scrum Master's role is to serve the team, not the management. And the primary responsibility, one of the primary responsibilities of the Scrum Master is make the team look good. When I say make the team look good, see and search for opportunities wherein you can get the team showcase their accomplishments. Not that I as a Scrum Master will go and showcase my team's accomplishment. I'll take my team and showcase their accomplishment. It could be in the community of practices, it could be in the all hands meet, or it could be in various forums. Make sure that you make the team feel good. So showcase the team, put the interests of the team first. That should be the role of us. That should be the approach that the Scrum Master should take, rather than being a secret agent to the management. Well, this is the last. So I call them as a frustrated Scrum Master. So a very good Scrum Master who has got all the traits that I just spoke about and who doesn't have any of these anti-patterns that I spoke about, he begins a wrong ecosystem. When I say ecosystem, the entire organization setup, it could be the team composition is incorrect, the team is not cross-scaled, the management doesn't understand the agile properly, probably the appraisal system promotes individual behavior rather than a collaborative or a team behavior. It could be anything. The list can go on. A good, true Scrum Master being in the wrong ecosystem is also an anti-pattern. Of course, nothing on wrong of the Scrum Master said. However, having said that, a Scrum Master is also a coach. He or she needs to take that stand and try to push back and see what can be changed in the ecosystem. Yes, it is a tough ask, but the journey is beautiful. If you are able to do that, you'll get a good night's sleep. Well, this is what I had. If there are any questions.
There are many questions. I'll go with YouTube first and then we'll come to you. Come to Zoom. So in YouTube, I think one question we have not touched is Madhu asked about what if a Scrum Master is not empowered by organizations for implementing some stuff of agile practices?
I think I answered it. Scrum Master is also coach. It's unfortunate, Madhu, because the management probably is not able to appreciate what the agile is all about. So you probably take the help of a coach or your enterprise coach, or you'll have to find ways and means of doing it. There's no silver bullet answer to it, Madhu. So I would say, as a Scrum Master, I should understand it thoroughly from a values and principles point of view. And if I can showcase and if I can explain it to my management, see, from the management point of view also, if someone who's there in that position has reached that position because of some credibility. So you have that candid talk with the management, and I'm sure you should be able to make that change, Madhu. Don't give up.
All right. We'll go to the next one. Will Cancino. Number 11. I think probably your number 11 anti-patterns. But the Scrum Master won't have much to work on if that is the case.
Number 11 is? So if I understand... Can you unmute or is it from YouTube?
It's from YouTube.
Okay. So probably what... I forgot the name of that person. So probably...
Will Cancino.
So Will, what I understand from your question is it's okay to be a Scrum Master for more than two or three teams is what I understand that you are trying to tell. It comes from that thought process that a Scrum Master's role is all these anti-patterns that I explained. Because I've seen Scrum Masters even for just being for one team, they struggle for time. There's so much to do. So it is something that you have to experience it and then only you have to you'll get the feel of it. Otherwise, what will happen is if it is more than two or three or four teams, we are reducing ourselves to become a clerical Scrum Master. So the management will reduce us to a clerical job. So that's what I can say, Will. So it is a contextual question, but a Scrum Master's job is a full-time job. That is something that I can vouch for. Being a Scrum Master for and done something wrong, being an agile coach, that's what I can vouch for, Will. It's once again a contextual question.
All right. We'll go to the next question from Devanjan. It's anti-pattern 13 occurs when Scrum Master is expected to be T-shaped.
Yeah, I think we spoke about it. See, as long as I have that maturity level and I can be true to the Scrum Master role also and not mix up with my development or my testing or role, it's okay. But it takes time to beat to that. So my advice would be initially let me master my Scrum Master role and then I'll dedicate 50% of my time to develop as a developer. That's okay. But not that I give only 10% or 5% and then I've reduced myself to a clerical Scrum Master. I think we answered that question.
All right. So Devanjan Sengupta's next comment. Awesome, Mahendra. I like most of your scenarios and anti-patterns. We are on anti-pattern 16 as I type this. This leads to leadership also looking for velocity as a productivity metric, for instance. Okay.
Yeah. This is an unfortunate thing. See, velocity, just because it is not that physics velocity. So how fast the car is going? No. So if I had the liberty to change this term, velocity by some other, I would put a big phrase: the quantum of work delivered sprint on sprint by the team on a consistent basis is what would be my word. What would be my sentence to replace this term velocity? So the unfortunate part is just because people are relating it to the physics velocity, it gets mistaken. So as a Scrum Master, I should be able to explain why velocity is not a measure of productivity to whoever is asking for it, Devanjan.
Okay, I'll go to the next point again from Devanjan. Fortunately, anti-pattern 17 is quite new to me. Which one was 17? Oh,
secret agent. Okay. I've seen a lot of this.
Anti-pattern 18, this is when learning starts for a Scrum Master. I wouldn't call this an anti-pattern. This provides a perfect opportunity to coach the ecosystem.
Excellent, Devanjan, you made my day. You made my day. So Scrum Master is a coach, and look out for this opportunity. Go for it. Change the ecosystem, and that journey is beautiful.
All right. Next one is Anji Babu Sanagapalli. Please give some tips or scenarios how to resolve the impediments in the team.
So this is once again contextual.
I'm not able to pronounce his name. This one is Anji Babu.
You're on Zoom, if you can.
No, it's YouTube. I'm still going into YouTube.
Okay.
So probably you can park this question because this needs little time to answer.
Makes sense. Yeah. Sorry, Anji Babu. So we'll take it up towards the end.
Yeah, Madhu mentioned. Thank you, sir. Thank you both. Then we have one more at Johnny Pat. Why organizations not hiring more Scrum, maybe Scrum Master rather than Project Manager? They show called delivery manager and project managers doing nothing compared to Scrum Master.
I'm sorry, Niradri, I lost that question. If you can.
Okay, why organization not hiring more Scrum Master rather than project manager? The show called delivery manager and project managers doing nothing compared to Scrum Master.
You can answer that, Niladri, because I'm still not able to grasp the question.
I'm still trying to understand the exact motto of this question, because if you are comparing organizations, project managers and Scrum Master compositions, that's actually a maturity of the organizations, whoever is actually running. Why you are comparing project manager and Scrum Master? Because whenever we talk about doing agile and being agile in that context, we always need to think from a leadership perspective what they think. Because if you want to go for an organizational level transformation, or everyone wants to work on agile, your leadership first needs to understand. And if they are hiring a Scrum Master and comparing with the project manager, that's actually not fair expectations from the manager. So that's what I can say. But again, if you are working as a Scrum Master, you can coach them, you can train them to make them realize how those are actually different from each other and what their role is. So this is actually cannot be covered in just a quick two-liner or three-liner. That can be going to a multiple debates. So if you have more questions or if you need something little more on that, you can comment over here. I'll quickly jump into, there are lots many questions we have on our Zoom. So Bismoy mention, what is Scrum Master always side with PO? Is it a anti-pattern? I am not able to understand. What is Scrum Master always side? So if you are saying if Scrum Master always showing partiality and talking on behalf of PO or preferring the PO's point of view?
Bishoy, you can unmute.
Bismoy, can you please? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So my question is like, what happens if a Scrum Master always takes sides with a PO rather than the Scrum team? So rather than the development team, is it a anti-pattern?
See, Bishoy, so it's not about taking sides and things like that. So as a Scrum Master, I need to understand what a Scrum Master's role is, what a PO's role is, and what the team's role is. See, for example, I'll give an example for your case, Bishoy. So the team is expecting that the PO should write the story paka paka, and it should be crystal clear. And the team, if the team is expecting that we as a team don't have any role in defining the story, that's a wrong thing from the team side. So in this case, yes, the Scrum Master should coach the team that story writing is a collaborative exercise. So then, so it is not about taking sides. It is about bringing that culture in the team. So rather, probably you might want to reword your this thing as, it is not about taking sides. It is about understanding the clarity of role of each one of the roles, be it the team, be the PO, be me as a Scrum Master, and taking a stance is the right thing to do. There's nothing wrong. So that is what I would say, Bishoy.
Okay, thank you.
All right, I'll go to the next question from Vumi Shah. Are we going to get this presentation?
It is there on your channel, right?
Maybe she's asking for the presentations that you are actually referring, but I don't think sharing the presentations will be possible at this point of time, but you will get the entire video. You can watch it as many times as you want.
It will be on my channel as well as Agile Digest. Yeah.
Okay, we'll go to the next question. Sayali, you ask, can there be break in two sprints? Can you please ask the question once again? I want to understand what exactly you mean by break in two sprints.
Do you mean to say
that there should be a duration gap from one sprint to next sprint?
Yes. As you know, you mentioned currently that you know, the vehicle gets overdrive. So I thought as I have been working as a Scrum Master for last 9 months, I have seen the sprints are going back to back.
Experience I want to share on this context. I was working as a Scrum Master for one of the organizations, and so that point of time, Scale Agile was not there. The innovation and planning, especially IP iteration kind of thing was not there. But what they used to do, they said, okay, we will be working on 2 week sprint, but we will be starting somewhere around Monday, for let's say Monday. Next week, Thursday, we'll close the sprint. That Friday, we'll keep it no work. We'll do innovations, we'll do planning, and any kind of relaxations you want. That they used to call it as a lab day. And again, they start it on the next Monday. So there are different ways you can practice. Mahendra, you can add your experience and views as well on this question.
Yeah, I lost my connection a little bit over here. So I'm back. I heard your comment. So while you were talking of IP sprint, and yes. So Sayali, so I understand where you're coming from. So it's because if you look at it from just a team member point of view, 2 weeks is a project. It's a 2 weeks is a deliverable. I need to have a potentially shippable increment at the end of the 2 weeks. So that is where the principle of constant pace comes in. So it is not about, so if at all I'm expected, if we are expected to work every day 8 to 12 hours or 10 to 12 hours, it's wrong. So that is where the constant pace, so the team has to figure out what is a constant pace. So if that is arrived at, this burnout will not happen. And as Niladri mentioned, you can have an IP iteration and sprint like that. That is from the
Scale agile perspective, but so what I mentioned, I think at that point of time your network was not there. So there was an example I have given for one of the client. They used to do 2-week iteration, and they started, for an example, on Monday. The next week, Thursday, they used to stop the sprint. And Friday, they used to keep for innovation one day. They used to call it as lab day. Any kind of organizational training, practices, relaxations. So that's all how you want to organize. But don't, if you are doing something like that, my suggestions will be practice as a whole, not for one team. So the entire organization should practice in the same pattern. So that's what I'll suggest if you want to implement something like that.
Yeah, very true. In fact, we all, I think most of us would be using Jira. So you know how Jira came into the picture. Atlassian is the company which owns Jira. So Jira, when I was using Jira during my development days, it was just a bug tracking tool to track the bugs. Over a period of time, and they had this innovation day, whatever, Niladri was mentioning, in that process or in that by having that as setup, the ideas came from the staff and the employees of the organization, and they figured it out that it can be used as a good lifecycle, agile lifecycle management tool itself. So that's a very so in fact there are so many companies who make a lot of money by giving that one day innovation day rather than their run-of-the-mill business as usual work. So it is not about, once again, to answer to your question, Sayali. So let's assume that none of this is there. So we don't have innovation day, we don't have IP sprint, so if you're running the team at 100% utilization, then that's an anti-pattern. We spoke about that. So ensure that the team don't get burnt out. That is one of the primary role duties of the Scrum Master. Should look out for it, Sayali.
All right. So I think that answered the questions. We'll go to the next.
That did. Yeah. Thank you great. So much, Niladri and Mahendra. Thanks.
Thank you.
We'll go to the next question from Prakash. Anti-pattern 8. Push Scrum Master. What happens generally? Scrum Master asks senior or old member of the team to assign the task or distribute the task. Yeah, that's an anti-pattern.
This has been already answered by
Mahendra. We spoke about it.
Right. Asit Pal asks, blind Scrum Master, is it always Scrum Master's responsibility to find the impediment, or it's shared responsibility of dev team and Scrum Master to find the impediment?
No. What I'm telling in the blind Scrum Master, see, there are certain individuals, for example, we are all have our own characteristics. Some people are introverts, some are extroverts, some have got problem with the language. There are quite a few ways. Some are by nature don't speak up a lot. So this is what I'm referring to here. Because we are working as a team for a long time, as a Scrum Master, I can figure out that this person is, or someone is shy, or someone is afraid to open up and tell that there's an impediment. So this is what I'm referring to. So a Scrum Master should need to look out for those signs and ensure that the impediment is spoken and that is resolved. That's what I'm referring to.
All right. YouTube comments, please hold on for a moment. There are a couple of questions we still got on Zoom. We are going one by one and we come to YouTube as well. We'll go to the next question from Mathi Raja. Most of the Scrum Master role, they are expected to technical skills. So most of the Scrum Master role, they are expected to be technical skills. I think we have talked something related to this, right, earlier?
Yeah. We spoke about it. You can check. Did you have anything in specific? I don't want to.
Mathi, did you got your answer earlier, or you have specific some different questions in mind? Okay. We'll go to the next question. I think that is Narasim Hardy. Scrum Master should not ask anyone to assign or himself team pick up the stories. I think he answered the question. Next one, Vikram. Scrum Master is expected to be taking over the technical challenges of the team. What can we do? I think we also talked about that. Again, this is related to the expected technical skills.
Yeah.
I'll go to Rahul Agarwal. How about Scrum Master and Product Manager? Or I'm not sure PM is, I will be take it as Product Manager, the same role, being the same role. I think we also talked about that. Those are actually having two different roles, and they, if one person is doing that, there will be a conflict of interest as well, and this they will not be able to. Yeah, so that's a very big anti-pattern.
So a product owner and the Scrum Master being the same person is a very big anti-pattern, because at the end of the day, the one the product owner's primary responsibility is the dollar value. So invariably, if I'm asked to play both the roles, the dollar value will take the precedence, and I'll end up probably compromising on the values and the principles and protecting the team and the main responsibility of the Scrum Masters. So that's a very big no-no. Others is still okay, Scrum Master and the developer, Scrum Master and tester. I'm not advising it, but it's a lesser sin to have.
Okay, Vikram's next question. I have heard organization expecting Scrum Master to do code. Is it a fair practice? It's getting difficult to find a job as Scrum Master. I think we also talked about that Scrum Master as a technical skills. We'll do little faster because there are many other questions we have in pipeline. MD Omar asks, if Scrum Master work like a dictator rather than explaining or solving the problem, then what should agile team do?
What should the agile team do? So that's an anti-pattern. So what should the agile team do? I don't have a silver bullet answer for this, Mohammed. I guess it's Mohammed. So yeah. It's all that you can do is the team can approach the management. Everything is in place, but if my Scrum Master is a dictator, so the team can approach the management. That's what I would say.
Okay, yeah, see, again, if Scrum Master is working like a dictator, maybe to my view, the Scrum Master is not having enough awareness. He's not a true Scrum Master, because Scrum Master, yeah, who we think should be coach the team, and that person himself or herself is not following it properly, then we may need, the team may go to the agile coach and talk about some trainings or somewhere where we can improve that areas.
Yeah, true.
Okay, so we'll go to the next question from Bhumi. When there is a constant conflict between PO onshore in bracket and development team offshore in bracket upon estimations or for definition of ready or done, then Scrum Master from offshore role gets into harmony Scrum Master. Is it an anti-pattern?
This is coming from the erstwhile mindset, wherein the PO, I would say the PO is coming from the client side, is what I'm guessing. So the PO is sitting in the on-site, and the Scrum entire team is sitting here in offshore. And we are having challenges. This is coming from the earlier mindset. So the thing here is the estimates are always owned by the team. It was about estimates, right?
Estimates and DOD, DOR.
Yeah. So, see, once again, this DOR and DOD is a collective artifact, though it is not an artifact per se in the Scrum Guide, the collective thing that it has to be co-created with everyone in picture. The PO cannot define the DOD in isolation, neither the team can define the DOR in isolation. And these are all work in progress running documents. Please revisit them frequently. I would suggest take retrospective as, take 10 minutes of your retrospective. Is our DO or DOD still current? Do we have to change something in that? Do it that way. Then things will fall into place.
Okay, so the next question I'll go, that is from Sefali. Sometimes teams starts talking, taking advantage of agile estimation technique, and there is no output at the end of the sprint. Every time there are spillovers. So if Scrum Master starts questioning why to find the reason, is it anti-pattern? Does it come under command and control?
No, so here the team needs to be coached. So that is where the Scrum Master need to put on the coaching hat. The team needs to be coached. So So when you say spillover, I would say one of the key aspects of one of the key values of Scrum is commitment. So the focus, openness, respect, commitment, and courage. So commitment. So when you say commitment, does the team understand what commitment means? So I generally give this example in my whenever. So commitment is like in my 30 plus years of adulthood, I have never seen a marriage getting postponed. That is commitment. Until unless one of the bride or the bridegroom defaults and runs away, never I have seen a marriage getting postponed. That is commitment. So does team understand what is commitment? And you should have to get into the deeper into it. Why are they not committing? Or there are multiple factors that would come out there, Shefali. So you'll have to, the Scrum Master need to wear the coaching hat out there.
Okay.
And yes, we'll go. Upholding commitment is one of the primary roles of the Scrum Master. So questioning, say, I would rather not use the word questioning. Making the team realize that commitment is important is the way that the Scrum Master should take it.
Right. Okay. We'll take the next question. Learnator Mercy mentioned, you joined late. We'll go to the next question, Vikram. Yeah, Mercy, you want to talk about that?
No, I missed the training. I was looking forward to it, Mahindra. I forgot the timing.
Mercy, I was in fact looking out for you because I remember 2 weeks ago you exclusively spoke about this. But anyway, the recording is there, and we can always get in touch.
I'll watch it on YouTube.
Yeah.
Well done. Thank you.
Thanks, Mercy. We'll go to the next question. Vikram, how to identify impediments? Are Scrum Master responsible to solve all impediments, or should we enable team to resolve impediments?
We spoke about it.
Right. We'll go to Asit Pal. During sprint planning, if dev team plan less amount of work for entire sprint, how Scrum Master coach to team?
We spoke about it. The team should know that the team also need to understand what is commitment. And I even spoke, the Scrum Master should raise the bar. So it is not, so mediocrity is not, it doesn't mean, self-management doesn't mean mediocrity. Self-management doesn't mean lazy fear is Scrum Master, no. So the Scrum Master should ensure that he or she raises the bar also. So once again, the Scrum Master puts on the coaching hat.
Okay, I can see two people, you have raised your hand, but before we go into that, let's cover a couple of the questions we are getting it from YouTube. Sai Jose, questions from YouTube. How should performance management work?
Can we take it last? Because this is something that probably the entire industry is struggling. Yes, Sai Jose, it is once again for the organization to handle. So there are multiple ways that is being done. And so there's no silver bullet answer for this, Saiju.
Yeah. We'll go to, should Scrum Master leave if the team is at the performance state?
It would be the ideal Nirvana state. So for that to achieve, I'm sure it will take a long time.
And at the time, when you actually talk about team, Scrum Master is also part of the team. So if you are thinking that moving someone who is performing better, you're removing something from the same team. After that, do you think they will be able to perform the same way? Because Scrum Master was also contributing something to reach to that performance. Again, Mahindra, you will be able to answer it better, I believe. You can answer it. If you are
very true, the team reached there just because of it's as good as telling, okay, Indian cricket team is doing very well, so we don't require a coach at all. So it's as good as telling that. So you require some binding force who's contributing to the whole cause. So the flip side is, okay, remove the Scrum Master and see how it will happen. I'm sure 9 out of 10 times the team will start falling apart. Just because there's a fulcrum out there, things are in place. Just because there's no problem, it doesn't mean that problems were not there. Problems were averted or problems are solved before it became a problem.
Okay, we'll go to the next question. Johnny Pat, why I'm asking, as Scrum Master, we can do coaching also, and also we are doing all the tracking in sprint, but company give credibility for to product manager for tracking a team to thought not part of the scrum.
Once again, tracking, I would say, tracking the team is not the role of the Scrum Master. To be honest, you might be surprised when I tell this. The sprint burn down chart, who owns the sprint burn down chart? The team owns. Who tracks it? The team owns. And that is what is the Scrum Master's job, to make the team self-manage. He or she can make sure that the conversations happen rather than tracking. So tracking the team, I have an objection to the word that tracking the team itself, that is not at all a role of the Scrum Master. It would fall into any one of these project manager Scrum Master or a pushy Scrum Master or a utilization Scrum Master. Tracking the team is not an expected from a Scrum Master.
Okay, I'll go to the next question. Atul Kumar Tripathi, I don't have much strong experience as Scrum Master, but just supporting Scrum Master while I was a test lead and test manager in my project. I am PSM 1 certified. I didn't got what exactly the question is, but he has the next comment. Any short course or videos I can refer to get the practical hands-on of what activities Scrum Master does on day-to-day basis, not just theoretical source, but more of a practical knowledge.
Niladri, you can answer that.
Yeah, so see, there are lots of YouTube videos there. There are lots of articles there. Even in Agile Digest, we have a couple of videos that talks about each and every part a Scrum Master should do, at what is their roles and responsibility, what exactly they do at different ceremonies. Those are kind of different activities in theories, but practically we do few webinars where we talk about the case studies, and practically you will not be able to get it in some forms of videos, because the practical experience you will only get once you will start involving over there. But at least you understood the fundamentals, you can practice that, and that practice will make you more experienced on that area. Okay, so Atul Kumar says, sorry, this might be a bit out of scenarios. I'll go to the next question from Debanjan. This is how I would answer the question on teams working 8 to 12 hours every day. Maybe it's good to read this in Agile principle. Okay, I'm not sure, able to relate on what context that was.
The principle of constant pace.
Right. Okay, Devanjan, next question. Agile process promotes sustainable development. The sponsors, developers, and users should be able to maintain a constant pace indefinitely.
That's a principle that he's referring to. Yeah.
Okay, Atul Kumar's next question. I was able to manage the team as I was already part of it as TM, but any new scenarios might put me through situations. So Atul, we can cover that sometime later. Need help as my new project work will start soon. Okay, we can take that also separately. We'll come to Pravalika, who asked, how can I present the dashboard reports to stakeholders? Can you please suggest any tool? Okay, let me answer that. See, any dashboard or a report that comes at the last, because when you're primarily talking about anti-patterns, you need to first understand what's the Scrum guide and principles, and as a Scrum Master, how you can coach the team better. Then when you come about dashboards and metrics, it's actually not mandatory. when you create some dashboard and metrics, first you try to find out why it is required, for whom you are creating, what value it is giving. And if you identify that, because it's not mandatory as a Scrum Master, you have to generate some metrics and you have to generate some dashboard. It all depends if your organization's needs, if they are organizations having integrating multiple inputs from different team as a program level, you just try to find out what contributions from your team level you need to give. Don't have any metrics to track the performance of the team members or team. So I think, Amendra, if you want to add something on that point.
Yeah. So probably what the question was is, what are the various tools? So see, metrics should, so that's where the information radiators should play a role. So, and that is where the transparency also should play the role. So the management asking for multiple reports and the same thing in different form is once again an anti-pattern from the management side itself. Everything is transparent, everything is on the wall, whatever you want to go and see. So that is where the Scrum Master should put on the coaching hat, is I would say. So, and once again, we spoke about the metric somewhere in one of those anti-patterns. What is the metric that it is really adding value? Be cognizant of that fact and be critical of the metric that you want to report on. So we can, that is a different topic itself altogether, on the various matrices and the anti-patterns with the various matrices itself.
Okay, there was another question from Srinivas. How Scrum Master role change compared to Scrum and SAFe? Okay, that's altogether, I believe, a different context we are going into. We can take that later. Devanjan Sengupta, message retracted. We'll go to the next question of Devanjan, where he asks, Scrum Master should read the 5 Scrum values if he is being a dictator. Okay.
Very true.
Devanjan Sengupta mentioned Jira should be able to give you these details. I think that's maybe an answer to Pralavika. Pralavika says, I mean, what is Scrum Master role in presenting to stakeholders other than Jira that are the other, what are the other tools? Devanjan already mentioned to Srinivas, in my opinion, Scrum Master role is framework agnostic, so nothing changes. Okay, well, Pralavikar questions about the previous question that we are talking about. So tools, there are hundreds of tools are available. You can go for Jira's inbuilt tool, plugins of Jira, do it in Excel, take your data to outside, build your own web app for tooling. That's totally up to you. There is no restriction or no guidance that you should use this tool over that tool. Johnny Pat asks, what is the role of a Scrum Master during grooming meeting? Okay, so we are actually going into a details role, but Mahendra, if you want to answer that, a quick role of a Scrum Master during backlog refinement or grooming meeting. Hello?
I was on mute. Sorry, I was on mute. So basically ensure that the stories which come into the backlog refinement have gone past the definition of ready, and ensure that the refinement happens. It is time boxed. Ensure that the product backlog is sufficiently healthy, and the stories which are coming into the refinement is really prioritized, and which is worthwhile to be refined and discussed, and facilitate a sizing. Generally, the stories are sized in story points. Facilitate the sizing in the refinement itself. In a quick nutshell, Niladri.
Great. The next point, Devanjan Sengupta, preferably avoid the word grooming. Even Scrum Guide dropped that word. Okay. Yeah, I think you answered that. During refinement sessions, Scrum Master can facilitate dialogues which help the stories meet the DOR. Maybe invest criteria could help. Okay. So seems like Devanjan is helping us on answering lots of questions. Thank you, Devanjan.
we are almost 25 minutes over. So if you can look at the questions in the interest of...
I think we have the last question. That's not also a question. Devanjan Sengupta mentioned, Invest is just a ready reckoner, but might help the Scrum Master. Okay. That's pretty much from our YouTube. I'll just quickly come to... couple of questions still we have over here. Thanks a lot, Mahendra Niladri. Thanks a lot for great learning. Asit Pal mentioned, is it required to estimate task in hour or story point of a user story? Okay.
It's not mandatory, Asit. So it is not mandatory, but breaking down the stories to task has got its own advantages. So you can ping me subsequently, or you can look up on my YouTube. There's one specific on sizing the story and breaking down to task. I've explained it there.
All right. Abhishek Chaudhary, thank you for the session. Can we have some session on how Scrum Master should coach the team and also a lesson on improving facilitation skills? We think we definitely can have, but we need to also think about when we can do that. And for any kind of webinars, it takes time to prepare the content. I don't have any content ready at this point of time. Mahendra, if you have, you can mention.
Not exactly on this topic, facilitation skills, no.
But that's a very good pointer. Maybe we'll work on that to make something in upcoming webinar. But we cannot commit when we can do that. We will talk about Richav to everyone. Thanks for the wonderful session. It's a great learning and everyone is saying thank you. I see one hand raised from Gavin Jaiganesh. Gavin, you wanted to ask something?
Yeah, Niladri. I have a very quick question. This is coming from the angle of rookie or technical anti-pattern that we were talking. Is it necessary for somebody to be a part of the dev team or I would say dev team or some other role within the dev team to be taking up the SM role? Or is it okay if somebody really new but experienced Scrum Master comes in and takes up the role in a already established team?
Perfectly fine. I'm sorry, I forgot your name.
This is Govind.
Govind. Perfectly fine. So in fact, Scrum Master need not even be technical. So anyone who can understand the values and the principles in the true spirit, and yes, the Scrum Master understanding technical words and being able to relate to the technical terms so that he's just not sitting as a dumb person in this thing is beneficial, but it is not really, really mandatory because I've seen people being a Scrum Master in a mainframe project while he or she doesn't even understand ABCD of mainframe as a technology. So the Scrum Master slowly learns the basics of this thing so that he can relate to the language that the people are talking. So it's perfectly fine.
All right. I think we have covered most of the questions. There are a couple of thank you from Saif Ali, Asit Pal. Thanks, Niladri and Mahendra. Vijay Singh, as a Scrum Master during debate conflict, how you should write the user stories. I think we can talk that sometime later. That's actually a little lengthy questions to answer. MD Omar, thank you. Such an informative session. In YouTube, finally, a few of the other questions. 5062 Mahesh, how Scrum Master helps product owner in grooming the product backlog and what are the different backlog refinement techniques? It's also a lengthy question because we cannot cover it in quickly as this point of time. Please answer my question before closing the session. Okay. Mahesh also mentioned. So, see, refinement technique. It's for me, I'll not be able to answer it quickly. Maybe Mahendra, if you can, about how. Yeah.
So I'll try to put it in a couple of sentences, Mahesh. So refinement technique. So it's basically coming from the skill set of the product owner. So the product owner should be really, really aware of the product, the domain, and he should be qualified to be a product owner. So that is a product owner anti-pattern. And the Scrum Master can help him or her understand how to slice a story, various strategies that can be applied to slice a story, or what is invest criteria. Those are the things that the Scrum Master can coach the product owner on. And refining the story is all about ensuring that the clarity of the story emerges. The clarity of the story emerges in while we do the story pointing exercise using poker planning, ensuring that the poker is executed or played in the true spirit of emerging the story. That's why we tell the stories of three C's: card, conversation, and confirmation. So that is where the refinement actually happens. So the Scrum Master's role is to ensure that that culture or that ambience is created in the refinement session. That's what I could say, Mahesh. I think it's from YouTube. He can't...
So he also in this, how Scrum Master assist PO when Scrum Master is not a technical person?
It's once again a contextual this thing. Probably when he means technical is when he means to say that he or she doesn't understand the role of the, or doesn't understand the product, is what I would assume. I hope if Mahesh could have been.
Yeah,
on Zoom,
so probably but... Mahesh, you can actually drop a email with little details, because from I'm reading from the chat and Mahendra is not able to look into the chat, it may take little more time. But if you just drop us a mail, I believe you already have the email ID, and you can drop us a mail, we'll reply you back with details, or we can have a separate conversations altogether. We are also going out of time. So I think that was the last questions that we have. And from Balu also, we got thanks a lot, Mahendra and Niladri, for a wonderful informative sessions. That's all we have right now. Mahendra, you can actually give the closer and conclude.
Sure. All that I'm saying is it's actually a learning process for me also. And I'm sure Niladri also would echo the same thing. It's always right. a win-win situation. It is not just learning for you, the participants. It's every time it's a learning session for me. Thank you so much for all of you.
And also everyone, tomorrow we have another webinar on Nexus. So if anyone thinks that may be something interesting for you, you can join that as well. Yeah, thank you, Mahendra. So yeah, Mahendra, thanks to you for taking your time and give everyone enlightening on some of the new areas or something we already are experiencing, and give an opportunity to discuss on that. Thanks, Mahendra, once again for this webinar. And we will also publish few of the upcoming webinars from Mahendra. He will be talking about, I think, the next one from Mahendra is talking about a demonstration on CI/CD, how exactly we'll be doing. And there are a couple of other ideas Mahendra also have, and we'll bring them up very soon.
Thank you, everyone. Thanks for a wonderful session. Have a good day and a good night. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Great. Then thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful